All right. Is the sound okay on the Facebook site? Just want to make sure that you can hear me. Is the sound coming okay? Right. Just give me a quick thumbs up if you can hear me okay, if the sound is coming okay on the Facebook side. Right, so I hope you guys can hear me okay on the Facebook. I'm gonna check one more time just to make sure that there are no audio issues. If you still have audio issues, let me know and then I'll do something about it. Okay, perfect. Awesome. Well, welcome everyone. I'm really excited to have our class back this Sunday. As you know, we meet every Sunday, 8 a.m. U.S. Pacific time, which is the time in the west coast of the U.S., primarily around California region and, Washington State, Oregon. But anyway, as you know, we meet every Sunday. And for those of you who are new to Hindi University, you can learn more about us by going to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/HindiUniversity. And you can find out more details. And for those of you who are also interested in learning about how to join the live session, you can go to tiny.cc/HindiUniversity and you will find all the courses structured systematically. That will give you an idea about how to join. Welcome Anya Ji. So let's get started with this class. As you know, the structure is fairly simple. We start with a simple topic and we practice those concepts and we make things complicated just to make sure that we can bring everyone along. And in the last two classes, we started with going over how to brush up all these concepts that we've learned in the last 12 plus years into like a quick 5 to 6 lessons. So my goal is in next 5 to 6 lessons, we'll try to cover all the topics in a condensed manner. So in the last two classes, we kind of covered all the Hindi tenses. Okay, we also covered Hindi models, which is how to use concepts called can, could, may, might, should. In Hindi tenses, we covered pretty much all the tenses, present, past, future, and within present, past and future, we covered indefinite, continuous, perfect, and also conditional tenses. So we covered a lot of topics. In this class, by the end of 30-40 minutes, you'll be able to brush up Hindi adjectives. You'll be able to cover Hindi adverbs. Okay. Hindi postpositions and not only that, you'll be able to cover Hindi interrogatives as well. So that's a lot of topic actually, and if you really go back to the detailed Hindi University lectures, for these four topics I probably have 30 to 40 videos just to cover these four topics. But here's the opportunity that if you don't want to go through those detailed videos, in this 30-40 minute class you will be able to cover these four major concepts. However, it does require some basic understanding of prior Hindi, basic understanding. Okay, we'll still give you an overview, but my goal is that after these 5 or 6 lessons we can have a live test, which will help me benchmark where everyone is, and which will also help you understand what your understanding of the current concept is, how do you score, and it will help you build the lesson plan for yourself for the subsequent classes. Okay, so ready Anya Ji, you have any questions before we move forward?
No.
Okay, perfect, let's get started. Is the audio okay Anya Ji? Okay. All right. So again, just to give you a quick reminder, when we started the last two lectures, we are keeping things simple. So I took one pronoun, which is I, taking one verb, which is make, and object is roti here. Roti, It's bread. Most of you are probably familiar with it. Okay, I is main, as you know, that's a pronoun, main in Hindi. Make is banana. To make is banana. And we learned variations of it, and our goal is to keep some of the things constant and really figure out how, when we use different concepts in Hindi, how they change the sentence structure. Okay, so I really want to start with the adjectives first. So Hindi adjectives. Anuji, do you recall some of the concepts from adjective class? What are some of the adjectives that will modify or give quality to our roti that we have here, object?
You mean the rules?
Examples are fine. I mean, we don't have to go into the rules yet, but if you recall some of the concepts, if you have to use any adjectives in the sentence, what will you like to use?
The adjective will end in E also, as it will be coordinated to roti.
Okay. So what is one example? I make small roti will be I make
achi roti.
Achi roti, very good, right? I make a good roti. So good is an example here is of an adjective, right? You can have small, you can have big, you can have sweet, you can have like hot or small, like few numbers. So I think the idea here is, like, you know, with the help of adjectives, you can give some quality to roti. So far, our sentences that we are learning, very simple sentences, right? I make roti. But what is the quality of roti? With the help of adjectives, you will be able to provide that, okay? So let's start with basic, as Anyaji pointed out. We'll start with some examples related to So here are the adjectives that I want to cover in Hindi. Adjectives that are based on shape. Okay, adjectives that are based on taste. Like swad of roti, how does it taste? Texture of the roti. And the fourth one is basically number. Okay, number, that's it. So our basic sentence was, I make roti. Which is main. For those of you who know, it's a simple sentence, present indefinite, which is main roti banata hu for a male, and for Anyaji it will be main roti banati hu. Okay, simple. Now, as you know that this context is missing, what is the quality we want to give it to roti? Okay, if the shape of the roti is round. Okay, if the shape, I think I missed the size, okay, the size also I want to cover. Okay, so let's say we want to cover the first one, which is small versus big. Okay, versus, yes, round. So shape and, you know, size, I'll cover it in simple, single one. How will you say these three things? Main small roti banata hoon. Big or round? Anuji, if I were to put you on spot.
For small, it would be main choti roti banati hu.
Main choti roti banati hu, okay.
For big, it would be main bari roti banati hu.
Okay, main badi roti banati hu, okay, good. And then?
Round, mujhe nahi pata hai.
Okay, round is a goal. गोल, ओके, मैं गोल रोटी बनाती हूँ, ओके, गोल, ओके, नाउ ऑल ऑफ यू नो इफ यू यू कैन सी दैट देर आर सम लाइक छोटी एंड बड़ी देर एंडिंग विथ ई, हाउएवर गोल इज नॉट एंडिंग विथ ई, ओके, कैन यू मेक अ गेस आनेश जी व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग छोटी एंड बड़ी बट यू नो देर एंडिंग विथ ई. Why we are using,
is it coordinating gender
That's right, right? So because roti is feminine, you are using choti. Adjectives also follow the same structure. Okay? If it is something else, like let's say, for example, if it is ladka, which is a masculine, it will be chota ladka, small boy. If it is bada, right, or elder boy, it will be bada ladka, right? So as you rightly pointed out, it's coordinated with the noun here. Okay, roti, choti roti, badi roti. Now this is uninflected. Goal remains the same, right? You know, I cannot say goal ladka, but if it is even if it is masculine or feminine noun, it will remain goal. It doesn't change the form. Okay, so those are the two forms of adjectives: inflected and non-inflected, uninflected. Okay, so good one. मैं छोटी रोटी बनाती हूँ, मैं बड़ी रोटी बनाती हूँ, और मैं गोल रोटी बनाती हूँ. Okay, so that's sort of size or shape. Now let's look at the taste of it. Okay, the same sentence will modify if you're talking about taste. What about if you want to say sweet? मैं स्वीट रोटी बनाती हूँ और मैं स्वीट रोटी बनाता हूँ और स्पाइसी. अनिश जी, यू वांट टू गिव इट अ ट्राई? और एनीवन एल्स ऑन फेसबुक?
I don't remember.
I think it's a simple one. Yeah. How do you say dessert? Dessert in Hindi? Sweets.
How do I say what?
Dessert, like, yeah. What are they known as in Hindi?
I knew.
Huh? You knew it?
let me check.
No, don't look up. No cheating.
Meat.
Meat, that's right. That's right.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So how do you say that?
But mithai is dessert, but it's also for spicy, it's also for sweet.
For sweet, you can say that, yes. So it will be, so mithai is sweet, but if you want to say, I make sweet rotis, it'll be,
mai mithai
roti. So it will become mithi. It's a quality basically, okay, mithi. Mitha is a taste, but then from there becomes mithai, which is like, you know, the dessert that you buy, like gulab jamun or like, you know, kaju katli or all the other sweets that you get on any of the festivals. Okay, so it's mitha versus mithi. So it's like but it's also like, you know, sometimes it is used for people how they speak. You know, for example, if somebody speaks very sweet, right? I mean, you say mitha bolta hai. That means, you know, or mithi bolti hai. That means he speaks sweet, or, you know, she speaks sweet, politely. Okay? So, main mithi roti banata hu for me, and for you, it will be main mithi roti banati hu. Spicy would be, Anish ji?
I know that spice is masala.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's right. So it will be masaledar. It will be masaledar. Okay? So main masaledar khana banati hu aur main masaledar roti banati hu. So I hope this makes sense. Like, you know, this kind of gives you an idea about the taste related adjectives. Okay? Now let's go to the texture. Okay, texture that I have here is, you know, let's say it's, for me, it's like a hot. Even though texture is like, you know, the feel of the, you know, the roti, but let's say you want to say that I make hot or warm rotis. Recall that? That's right, garam. Garam. Garmi is, it's like the, it's about weather and how you feel out. That's garmi hai or sardi hai. It's hot outside, but if you're talking about an object, it's like a bahut garam hai. Like, you know, let's say if somebody serves you, if you go to an Indian restaurant and you want hot chai, you will not say mujhe garmi chai chai, you'll say mujhe garam chai chahiye. Okay?
So it doesn't change in between female and
That's right. It doesn't. So this is uninflected. Like, mujhe garam chai chahiye, aur mujhe garam khana chahiye. I want hot food. So you can say mujhe garam, you know, pakode chahiye. Right? So that's you know, texture. Now let's go about numbers, you know. What about numbers? Let's say you want to talk about fewer numbers or you know, small number. So what is the adjective that you use for small number in numbers? Or and then big in numbers. You know the quantity related. So this is number or quantity. See, this is also a good test of your, you know, some of the adjectives. If you recall the
for big numbers, I would have used several, like bahutse or kahi.
That's right. So big, you are right about it, right? It will be bahutse. So let's say your again your basic sentence is still the same. Main roti banata hu aur main roti banati hu, right? And you want to say that, you know, I'll make a fewer rotis, you know, a few or small in quantity. It will be thodi. So now, because it's still a quantity, it will become plural. So you will say, main thodi rotiyan banati hoon. Or you will say, main thodi rotiyan banata hoon, if I'm saying it. Okay? Similarly, for big, as you say, bahut si. Or main bahut sari rotiyan banata hoon. Okay? Or let's say there are a lot of guests coming in my house. Okay? And, you know, I usually think of my mom because, you know, she's good and she makes very good. And so if a lot of people are coming, you know, her response will be, main bahut sari rotiyan banaungi. That I will make a lot of roti. So when guests come, we are not short on rotis. Okay, or if not many people are coming, you know, main thodi rotiyan banaunga or main thodi rotiyan banaungi. Okay, now the question online on Facebook from Bridget is, how do we know which ones are, which adjectives are inflected and which are uninflected? That's a good question, you know, which are inflected versus uninflected. So there's no one. Anishji, what's your response? How do you know which will change form, which will not change form?
If the adjective ends with the E or A.
So, example would be, so let's say it's a ladka and versus ladki. Okay? Chota versus choti. Is that what you're thinking?
Yeah.
Okay.
So for I was speaking about the adjective. If the adjective ends with A, then it'll change in A in plural.
Okay. So
it'll be choti ladki.
Okay. So chota and bada, right? That's a bada and badi. These are the adjectives. And these are the nouns. So what Anishji is saying, if it is, they're ending with A, chota, when you're using it with the feminine objects or nouns here, you will become choti. Similarly, bada becomes badi. Okay. However, if it is not ending with a, such as like sundar, beautiful,
then it doesn't change
because it's not ending with it. Like, so sundar ladka, sundar ladki, both of them are same. Now, while there are some basic rules around it, there may still be exceptions, right? But yeah, that's a good recall, Anishji. So let's keep going. I hope this makes sense. Main thodi rotiyan banata hoon versus main bahut sari rotiyan banata hoon. Okay. So let's see if there are any more questions. So the question is, can I say ziyada? You can say that. Main zyada for lot. So you can say that. Main zyada rotiyan banaungi. Like, I'll make a lot of rotis. But zyada is also like, you know, it's comparison, right? I mean, kisse zyada? It has to be like, you know, let's say if I'm comparing myself with Anishji. So main Anishji se zyada rotiyan banaunga. Like, I'll make more rotis than, you know, than Anyash ji. Okay, so I hope that makes sense. So this kind of covers are adjectives, right? I mean, which are sort of qualifying the nouns that it is being used with. So in just a quick lecture, we were able to cover the size related adjectives, shape, taste, textures, and quantity. Okay, our base form is simple. We are keeping the pronoun as main, I. Our verb is simple, which is we are keeping it as banana, to make. Okay, which is how it is changed to banata. Now, in the detail lecture, I do recommend you to change and use other pronouns as well, such as aap, you, hum, you know, we, they, you know, which is, you know, way. Okay, you can make variations here. Okay, you can make variations to roti also. Right now we are only using roti, but you can change this also. Okay, you can change the verb as well. You don't have to have banana, right? I mean, but for our purposes, you know, and the, you know, my goal is that, you know, even in the future you want to just cover all the concepts of Hindi in the 4 or 5 lectures. This is, should be our go-to source. Okay, any questions, Anish ji, before we move on to the next topic? Okay, perfect. Now let's do adverbs. Do you recall what was the adverbs about? Anish ji? Okay. So, it was another interesting topic that we covered, adverbs. Okay. Now we covered, like, you know, how, like in the manner the rotis you make, manner. Okay, we also covered in the past adverbs related with, you know, locations, okay, or when, location related adverbs, okay, and, you know, sorry, this one is where, location related. Okay, when it's about time related, we cover time related adverbs, and then we covered extent, you know, how. So how we covered actually, so let's cover these three first, which is basically the manner in which you make roti, when you make roti, and where you make roti. Okay, and if time permits, we can do more. Okay, so far again, like very simple sentence, I make roti, main roti banata hoon, and for Anish ji, main roti banati hoon. Now, what about manner? You know, let's say she makes it quickly versus I'll probably make slowly. Okay, now it's enhancing the sentence, you know, in a different way. So you no longer just say, oh, I make roti, but like you are able to use some good advanced concepts as well. Okay, how do you say this, Anya ji? You can say, yeah, easily with difficulty.
Kaise,
that's right, right? Right, so the question is like, you know, let's say you, I'm saying you, I make roti, main roti banata hoon. You can ask me a question, aap kaise roti banate hain? Okay, I can say I make roti quickly. How will I say that?
Quickly?
Or I make roti slowly. Or I make roti very easily, because it's, you know, let's say I do not, but let's say if I have to make a case, because let's say if I've been making it every day, it's very easy for me. Or I can say I make roti with a lot of difficulty. And it's for anyone on the Facebook as well. If you want to try, you know, you can give it a try. Okay, awesome, Tisa ji, very good. She said for the first one, main roti quickly. You said jaldi banati hu, very good. How about anyone else? What do you guys think? As I said, like, you know, you should always try. There's no negative marking here, right? So it's good that you try. Easily could be aram se, that's right.
Quickly and slowly,
Which one? Quickly and slowly
quickly
you run.
And slowly, I don't know.
Okay. Okay, so let's see. Maddie is saying, main roti jaldi banati hu. Awesome. Right? So quickly is, main jaldi roti banati hu. Most of you have said it right. And main jaldi roti banati hu. Okay. So let's say if some guests come to your house and they're in a rush, but you do want to serve them. Okay. And, you know, I don't want them to run, like go away without having or enjoying the hospitality. I can say, I'll make it quickly. Which is how will you say that, Anishji? I will make it quickly. Main?
Main jaldi roti banati hu.
No, I will make it quickly. Don't go. Yeah.
Main jaldi roti. I'm sorry.
No,
long time ago.
No, I know. That's why it'll come quickly. It'll come quickly or slowly.
Yeah.
Yes,
no,
yes. Future. Banaungi. Okay, banaungi.
Banaungi.
Right. So let's say I come to your house, okay, and you don't want me to leave without. What do you make the best? Tell me now.
Chocolate cake.
Chocolate cake, okay. So you don't want me to leave without having the chocolate cake, okay? In this case, we'll just use the word bake karna. Okay? How will you say that?
Main jaldi chocolate cake banati ho.
Okay. Banaungi.
You want me to speak in future?
Future, yeah. So, I mean, this is an example I'm giving, but at the same time, I'm trying to quiz you for future indefinite.
Okay. So it will be main jaldi.
Banaungi. Or you can say for bake karna, main jaldi bake karungi. Okay? Yeah. Okay? Good. Slowly would be, you said already, right? Slowly would be?
Aram se.
So easily would be aram se. Slowly would be, you can say dhire dhire. Main dhire dhire roti.
Yeah.
You'll say it twice, you know, I think this is more appropriate here. You know, main dhire dhire roti banata hu aur main dhire dhire roti banati hu. Easily, as some of you said, aram se, aram is, aram se roti bana leti hu. Or if you were to go back to the previous class where you used, you know, I can make roti easily, right? You want to say using models. And if you don't know models, I really recommend you watch the previous class, right? So you can say, main aram se roti bana sakta hu, or main aram se roti bana sakti hu. Okay? With difficulty would be, Anishji, mushkil se, okay, usually you can say, mujhe mushkil hoti hai, I face difficulty, aur main mushkil se roti banata hu. Okay, I hope this makes sense, and I'm not going too fast, the intent here is to kind of give you gist of all these topics, you know, so that a lot of time, you know, I feel that, you know, each lecture is so long, one hour long, that you forget by the time we are in the 3-4 weeks we make advancement, you've forgotten all the previous topics. So for me as a teacher, it's a challenge, right? I mean, how do I make sure all the students retain that information? So hence these 5-6 quick refresher, okay, before the exam, so that you guys don't complain that Ashu Ji didn't give us time and just quiz us for everything. So this is sort of your manner in which, you know, you can say you make roti. Now there is no easy way for you to, you know, to you just have to remember some of these. Like, there is no way for you to, for me to create a rule in which you don't have to memorize dhire dhire or aram se or mushkil se or jaldi. You just have to remember it, okay? If you find it difficult, you can still say, main quickly roti banati hu. Initially, or you can use the formula, Hindi mein quickly ko kya kehte hai, that, you know, I hope most of you know, or Hindi mein slowly ko kya kehte hai, at least you're asking the person who knows Hindi in Hindi, okay, or Hindi mein easily ko kya kehte hai. So that's the other thing I can think of. Now let's talk about where, okay, location related adverbs. Do you remember any of those, Anish ji? Location related adverbs. Where?
Kahan.
Where do you make rotis? So let's say the question is here. I make roti here, or I make roti there. Okay. Or it could be inside, outside. Inside, outside. These are all adjectives, but location related. I make roti here. Let's say you come to my house and you ask me, Ashuji, where do you cook or where do you make roti? Or where do you work? Right? I can say I work here, I work there, I work inside or outside. I mean, I'm just giving example of location related adverbs. So for you, Anirji, as well as for people who are watching live on Facebook, how will you say that? I make roti here, I make roti there, I make roti inside and outside. So take your time and complete it.
For here, it would be me yaho roti banati ho.
Okay, awesome.
For there, it would be me vaho roti banati ho.
Very good, right? So for here, you said is me yaha roti banati ho or me vaha roti banati ho. Okay, what about inside or outside? Okay, inside, okay, yeah. So, yeah.
Maybe different,
no? No, it's okay, keep going.
And for inside or outside?
Which one? You want to start with inside first?
Yeah, inside is ke andar.
Okay, so you can say kitchen ke andar, like, you know, because when you're using a postposition, there has to be something before. So either you can say main
ghar ke andar roti banati hu.
Okay, ke andar, so I'm just gonna say andar. Okay, ghar ke andar or kitchen ke andar or okay, outside.
Outside is bahar.
Bahar, very good. So I'm gonna write 2a, so you don't read it as bahar. Bahar is also a name, but bahar is different. Bahar is a name. Bahar is, you know, outside. So can you give an example kitchen of outside, Arneshji? Bahar?
Bagi ke bahar roti banati hu.
Kiske bahar?
Bagi. Bag.
Oh, garden.
Yeah.
Garden ke bahar. Okay, main bagiche ke bahar aur bag ke bahar roti banati hu. Awesome. So this kind of covers location related adverbs. Now there's no limitation, to be quite honest with you. There's a big list. If you want to get confused, you know, you can just go over location related adverbs. You can look for those adverbs in your language, right? I mean, and pretty much they're segmented into these, you know, major topics. But for me, I want to give you the idea behind it. So at least you understand, like, how, you know, I make roti can be enhanced, okay? Right, let's keep going. So now we'll do time-related, okay? Time-related adverbs. When? When is?
Cub.
Very good. When do you make roti? In fact, when I cover interrogative, I'm going to cover it. So let's see, cub. Cub is for that. Let's say you want to say now. I'm making roti right now, or now, or you want to say
today.
Okay, very good. Today. Still. Still, right? Or later. Later or soon. Okay, so let me erase this one. Or soon. So these are all time related adverbs. So, you know, let's say I am complaining to my mom or my you know, anyone. When will you make roti? And the answer is, I'll make roti. I'll make it soon. Okay, or I'll make it now. I'll make it today. I'm still making it. I'll make it later. Okay? Different responses. Okay? But your base thing is still the same. So again, as before, your task is, how will you say, how will your sentence be modified? I'll make it soon. I'll make it now. Today. I'm still making it. I'll make it later. Take your time, and then I think we can do a quick practice. Okay, very good, Tessa Ji. So, okay, very good. So Maddie, you will say, Abhi is, that's right, Abhi is now. Soon. Okay. Let's see what other guys can think of. What do you think, Anesh Ji? I'll make it soon. How will you say, I make roti, but I will make it soon. So pay attention, this is future indefinite now. Main. Which one? Jaldi hi, or jaldi hi. Main jaldi hi roti banaungi. Okay, soon. Okay, main jaldi hi roti banaungi. I know jaldi is also quickly, but it's also used for soon. Main jaldi hi roti banaungi. Okay. For example, you know how you wash the. You go to theater and they show you before theater all the promos of the movies, that this movie is coming soon. Okay, they'll say ye jaldi hi aa rahi hai. Okay, right? So it's, you know, so it's a good way to remember it, right? Because movies are quick to remember. So jaldi hi aa rahi hai. Okay. So what about now, Anish? How will you say, I will make roti now? Abhi, very good. Yeah, this one you should know, right? Main abhi roti bana rahi hun. Okay, today?
Aaj.
Very good. Main aaj roti bana rahi hun aur main aaj roti banaungi. What about still?
Abhi bhi.
Okay, abhi bhi aur abhi tak. Main abhi tak roti. So, let's say, you know, you want to say, I'm still making rotis. How will you say that? Full sentence.
I don't know anymore anything. Bana rahi.
Very good. Main abhi bhi roti bana rahi hun. I think you're taking unnecessarily pressure. I think this is.
No.
Yeah, okay.
Trying to put things in my mind.
Yeah, no, this is still good, right? This is still good. Main abhi tak, I'm still making roti. So, I'm still baking the cake. Main abhi bhi cake bake kar rahi hun, right? I mean, all of those are. What about later? I will make it later.
Baad na?
Yeah, that's right. So, main, I will make it later. Main.
Baad roti banaungi.
So, baad mein. Post position here. Okay, मैं बाद में रोटी बनाऊंगा और मैं बाद में केक बेक करूंगी. Okay, however you want to say it. Okay, so these are all time related adverbs. Okay, now there can be more, but let me see if there are any questions. Tisa ji saying मैं अभी रोटी बनाती हूँ. मैं अभी रोटी बना रही हूँ. Okay, that's right. So if you're making it right now and that's how you want to say it, then you will say continuous. Main abhi roti bana rahi hun. And Maddie ji, you're right. Aaj main roti banati hun aur bana rahi hun. That's how you'll say it. Okay. Now let's go back. And are there any other questions on this one, on the adverbs? I want to make sure we didn't go too quickly, right? So we covered adjectives. We covered adverbs. Let's see how are we doing with time. So 8:43. I can do quickly interrogatives as well. So that way, I will be able to cover all the things that I plan except postposition. So now we will do interrogatives very quickly. And interrogatives is like, you know, the way you ask questions. So let's say you mention to someone that you make roti or I make roti. Okay, what are the different type of questions they can ask you? Okay, if you want to go to journalism, you know, interrogative is a good topic. Or if your tendency is to, if you're a curious person, you know, who genuinely is interested in asking questions, interrogative is your go-to topic. You should know about interrogative. Okay, you really start with what. Okay, what do you make? Okay, generally you want to know about people. What do you like? What do you make? Then, you know, the next thing is how. How do you make it? Okay, another question you want to know. You're a curious person, right? How do you make it? Then is like, when do you make it? Okay, another question is where. Where do you make it? Okay, question. There's no limitation. You can even ask how often do you make it. So we covered what, we covered when, and why do you make it, right? You make roti, but what's the point? Why do you even make it, right? So not to make fun of it, but just want to make sure at least I can cover these five basic interrogatives. So, you know, you, all the questions or things you learned, with that you can pretty much stay engaged with, you know, Hindi conversation with anyone by asking these questions, okay? And this will give you time to understand the other person, and this will also help you understand in terms of listen to them in Hindi, okay? So how do you say, what do you make, Anish ji? So we have, I make roti. Let's say this was not even the case. This is the answer to what do you make. What do you make? Okay, how will you ask?
Kya aap banate hain?
So that is, do you make? What do you make would be? You make is aap banate hain. Right? You make is aap banate hain.
Using kya?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. So where will you put aap? So let's say I'm using plural. Aap banate hain.
Aap kya banate hain?
Very good. Aap kya banate hain? Okay, what do you make? Okay, और आप क्या पकाते हैं? Okay, और आप क्या पकाती हैं? You can say that मैं रोटी बनाता हूँ, और you can say मैं केक बनाती हूँ, और मुझे केक पसंद है. Okay, so that's your first interrogative. What do you make? Okay, what are you cooking today? आप क्या बना रही हैं? Very good question. It requires you to know interrogatives. You know about, you know, you know, the tenses already. The next was like, how do you make it?
So,
very good, right? So how is, how do you make it? Aap kaise banate hain? Okay, for example, I don't know how to make cake, so I can ask you, aap cake kaise banati hain? Okay, that's your postposition, or sorry, interrogative number two. How do you make it? Aap kaise banate hain. Okay, now that I've learned about that, you know that what do you make, and I know that how do you make it, now I'm really curious and I want to have it, right? And then I can ask you, Anuji, when do you make it? So I can invite myself to your place, and I can enjoy the cake. How will you say it? When?
Aap kab banate
hain? Right, aap kab, in this case, banati hain. Aap cake kab banati hain? And you can say, main cake har Sunday banati hu, or main, I make it every, har weekend banati hu, or you can say, har sham banati, every evening, right? So, I hope this makes sense, and you know, it's helping to you to, at least to think. I'm thinking, if I am in your position, I want to know all these variations, okay? And the order I should go, so I can if I have to learn any other language, how will I, you know, make advancement? Okay, now the next one would be where. Where do you make it? Very good, right? So that would be kahan. Right? Aap kahan banate hain aur aap kahan banate hain aur kahan banati hain. Okay? Now, last one I have, I hope you, I'm not going too fast and you guys are able to follow it. Last one is why. Why do you make it? Or why do you travel?
Why?
Yeah.
What is kyun? So that would be kyun
banate hain. Yeah. Or let's say if I'm asking you, why are you making too many rotis? Why are you making so many rotis? So many rotis. How will you say that? So it's an interrogative. It's an adjectives. Why are you making? Okay. So let's. I'm not putting any adverb, but let's say. If I have to, why are you making so many rotis? If I have to use any adverbs also, now, how will you say it? This kind of covers everything, right? It covers interrogative, adjectives, and adverbs in just one sentence. So look at it one more. So let's break it down now, right? So the pronoun here is you, which is aap. To make is banana, but which tense is it, Anishi?
Banara.
So it's present continuous, right? So,
yeah, sure.
Right, so
it's bahut sari roti, no? Ah,
that's right.
Now.
Now.
Okay. So, abhi bahut sari roti. No. Abhi aap bahut sari roti kyun bana rahi hain?
That's right. Aap abhi bahut sari rotiyan kyun bana rahi hain? Right? Let's say I come home and I see my mom making so many rotis and I can easily jump on. Aap abhi itni sari rotiyan kyun bana rahi hain? And she can say, no, because we have guests, kyunki abhi ghar pe mehman aa rahe hain. Like guests are coming to our house, right? So you see, you started with very simple, which is I make. From I make, you say you make, aap banate hain. From there, you're saying you are making, aap bana rahe hain. From there, like, why are you making, aap kyun bana rahe hain? Okay, aap roti kyun bana rahe hain? And then so many, aap itni sari roti kyun bana rahe hain? And then abhi, aap abhi itni sari roti kyun bana rahe hain? So it's an incremental thing. You start with small, you keep on building on it, right? So I hope today's lecture was useful for a lot of you, right? We covered three topics. We covered adjectives, adverbs, and interrogatives. I really encourage and recommend all of you to watch the last two classes as well. It's good because, like, you know, it helps you cover a lot of topics in just one class. One of the thing or the feedback I receive is like, Ashu Ji, you have so many videos. It's very hard to know where to start and where to end, right? So I'm making it easy for all of you so that you can do a quick refresher, right? And most of the time when I look at, you know, what other people are covering, even in universities, they don't go too deep, and I really want to, you know, all of you to start using advanced concepts in your day-to-day language, right? So I hope this will be helpful for you. So with that being in mind, we'll meet again next Sunday, and then I'll open it up for any questions. I think it'll be great if you share the classes. You know, the classes are free and they will be free, but it gives a lot of motivation. You know, if you share it on, you know, whichever forum you are more familiar with, you're more comfortable with, so like-minded people can join and we can have conversation, right? I mean, because you also want to interact with your friends in Hindi. So please do share it, and that's about it. We'll meet next Sunday. Thank you so much for folks who are watching live on Facebook.